Every time you toast bread, turn on a fluorescent light or use a computer, you're making use of quantum physics. In fact, if quantum physics didn't exist, you wouldn't be able to watch this video right now. But luckily, it does. This is what we call a particle, which has a definite position, while these are waves found in multiple positions, and the distance between two crests or two troughs is called wavelength, with which you can find momentum. Let's see what happens when two waves interfere. The places where two crests meet form a bigger crest, and the places where a crest and a trough meet, they cancel each other out, leaving regions of nothing at all. So when we combine waves of different wavelength, the places where two crests meet form a bigger crest, and crests and troughs cancel each other out. On repeatedly adding waves, we can increase such regions of nothing, and eventually we can form a wave packet, which has a clear wavelength in one small region, as there is nothing in the rest of the regions. This is a quantum object, which has both wavelength and a definite position. That's why the wave-particle duality of matter tells us that a quantum entity behaves as both waves and particles. This means all quantum objects have wavelength and hence they have momentum. Wait a second. So the quantum object we created could have momentum of any one of these waves it was made from. So now we aren't sure of its momentum. We can increase the certainty of momentum by adding lesser waves, but that would make the resultant wave larger and we would be uncertain about position. And to increase certainty in position, we have to add more waves, which would make us uncertain about momentum. So the more we know about one, the less we know about the other, and vice versa. Thus, it is impossible to simultaneously know the exact position and momentum of a quantum object. That's the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, where the position and momentum uncertainties are always greater than or equal to h over 4 pi, which is a very small number, hence this isn't observed in real life. When the uncertainty of one increases, the other decreases, and vice versa. The Heisenberg uncertainty principle tells us about the fuzziness in nature, a fundamental limit to what we can know about the smallest scales of creation. This takes down the idea of a perfectly predictable universe. And even though we cannot observe any of this with our naked eye, the applications of it are everywhere. And we owe all this to one of the most famous and fundamental ideas of physics, that of the minute particles that make up everything around us. My name is Nandita, and thank you so much for watching.